Ifi ke mo ifi ae me alea ke o mo marie ki he angahala I he ngahi pule. Oh, mama.
dear brothers and sisters, can I kindly ask you all to please stand as we may live in Halafihi. My dear brothers and sisters, before we commence with our family service, I'd like to just go over some housekeeping rules. There is no alcohol drugs or smoking allowed on the premises. Also, there's no recording of the family service in this chapel. There's no photos to be taken. We ask that you please abide with these rules, as this building is the house of the Lord, that we may treat it as if the Savior was here himself. So, brothers and sisters, the toilets are all found in the corridors. If you need to go to the bathrooms, just follow the signs and you'll be able to find the bathrooms. Other than that, we will commence. I know we're running behind time. Obviously, this is island time. You know, we planned for 5:30, but we wanted to start at 6 p.m. Brothers and sisters, family, friends, we extend a warm welcome to each and every one of you here this evening to this evening's family service of our beloved brother, Halafihi Tai. Presiding over this meeting is President Lakisa, First Counselor in the State Presidency. Up on the stand is Bishop Elisaya and his Second Counselor, Brother Tabelu. My name is Bishop Von Kalafi, and I'll be conducting this service. We'll open up our family service by singing together, I Feel My Savior's Love. And our opening invocation will be offered by Raylene Cafferty. Sorry, brothers and sisters, there's been a change to the opening hymn. If we could all please turn to page 294, Love at Home. We'll sing Love at Home. Thank you.
Heavenly Father, as we gather here together as thy sons and daughters, we pray that as we open this family service, that we may open it with a portion of thy Spirit. We pray that thy Spirit will be able to comfort those that are needing comfort, especially mainly the wife of Halafihi. We pray that we may gather here and support her at this difficult time as we depart with our brother. Heavenly Father, we pray that you may bless our families who can't be here tonight with us, but we pray that they may be able to feel thy love, feel thy Spirit, be able to join us for the live stream. We pray that they may be able to know that they are loved. We are so grateful for the atoning sacrifice of thy Son, Jesus Christ. We're grateful for the gospel that we have and the understanding that we have that families can be together forever. We pray, Father, that we may continue to be instruments in thy hands and that we may remember the teachings and be able to comfort and love one another. Lord, we pray that you may forgive us for our sins, our shortcomings and weaknesses. We ask that you may bless our families, that we may be able to be blessed with the spirit of unity, that we may celebrate in the life of Halafihi. We pray that you may bless Halafihi also and send him our love. We pray that you may bless his children, that they may continue to turn to thee in times of need, to always put their faith and trust in thee. We pray, Father, that you may bless the leaders who are here with us, the bishopric, his counselors. We know that they are the head of bishop in this world. He is the Moses in this world. We pray that Marlene and the rest of our families here in the board may be able to continue to heed to thy word. We pray that we may remember all the good things that we can remember to be able to celebrate my brother's life. We love thee so much, Father, and we pray for these blessings in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I'd like to thank Raylene for opening us up with the prayer, the Inviting Spirit, and also the music. I'd also like to welcome those who did not have the opportunity to be here and is able to meet with us via stream live. Brothers and sisters, our program is as follows. We will hear from our first speaker, Florina Sekona. Following Florina, we'll hear from Vaka Finau. Following Vaka, we'll hear from Sisipueki Ofengawa. And after Sisipueki, we'll hear from Elizabeth Mafileo. After Elizabeth Mafileo, we'll hear from Alipate Ofengawa and Joseph Ofengawa. We'll be followed by a family musical item. Florina.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. I'm grateful for the opportunity that I have to represent my dad. My name is Lina Sekona. I'm married to Sara Sekona, the oldest daughter of Stephen Tai, who is Lucille's older brother. Growing up, Halafihi was known as our uncle. because we were lucky enough to have everyone with us to even look out for you. He came to finish school in our home pool. He stayed with me and my brothers and my parents. When he came, anytime my dad talked to him, he was so annoyed. He never wanted to hear my dad tell him to do anything. But when it came to my mom, he listened. We had no blood relation to my mom, but that's the only one he would listen to. When my mom would yell, she treated Fiji just like any of us. When she would yell, Fiji would just smile and laugh. If he came and finished high school in 2 years, in America it takes 4. I'm sure everyone hears all the stories of Halafihi Tai. He did the same thing back home. He protected us. He never let anyone mess with us. Being my dad sends his love. And my brothers, and my mom. And we miss you. Thank you for always checking up on us, no matter the distance, it didn't matter. As time went, you always checked on us. And this place, and I know that this truth is true. I know that if we do what we have to do in this life, we're going to see in the next. Especially love to my cousin Sia and my first cousins. I love you guys all. I see this case in the next.
My name is Waka Otofei Kumapa Al-Kanafina. I'm the oldest of Loni Tofa Fina. Grateful. So grateful. So grateful to be blessed to know Fi. Times about Fi, I kind of ran out of good stories to tell. I thought today, out of all days, I'll be done crying. And as soon as, you bring Fi in, I can feel the tears already coming. I'm the oldest of 7. And just like Lena, we had the privilege of housing Fi. And Fi was introduced to us as an uncle as well. And my first time meeting Fi, I was intimidated by him. He's an intimidating guy, just by his physical appearance. But once you got to talk to him and know him, he's very welcoming. Yeah. He doesn't hold back his love for people. And it didn't take long for you to like Fi. Funny story about Fi, Grandma was telling us, we were talking a while ago about Fi, and she was telling me how Fi used to get bullied a lot And then she was tired of him, you know, getting pumped around school in his younger age. And grandma told me that she taught Fihi how to fight. And she told Fihi to protect themselves from everybody. And how grateful I am for grandma to teach him that, to fight. Because if he didn't fight, he wouldn't have made it over to California or Utah. If he was like me, it'd just be, oh yeah, it's all right. You know, I wouldn't have this opportunity to know that to know Fihi, to actually live with Fihi. It's quite the experience. I never met somebody so complicated, but set so simple. There was one time when, you know, when Fihi was living with us, my dad decided to take us to the movies. And back then, you know, movies weren't like 2 hours, 3 hours long. It was a good hour and a half, and you're right back home. So, you know, my dad packed us all up, and we asked Fihi if he wanted to come. He didn't want to come, so he stayed back. He stayed home. So we went and watched this movie, and we came back. And we just see a whole bunch of cars in our driveway, all these people outside. And my dad, he was angry. He was mad. He was like, this, he did not. He did not just throw a party while we was gone. And as soon as we got inside, my dad yelled at Fihi. He's like, Fihi, get these people out. And he did. And then as soon as he got everybody out and he was talking to everyone to leave and pushed everyone out. And he went to my dad and he apologized and he was like, man, I'm so sorry. It wasn't, you know, I just invited two friends and then everybody else came in. I was trying to get everybody out. I don't know what they were doing. I don't even know these people. And then my dad looked at him and he was like, Fihi, you know, it's fine, it's okay. You know, just don't let it happen again. And that was the last time that ever happened. Fihi was that type of person that he didn't dollar who you. If you're older than him, he knows his place. You know, if you tell him, don't do that again, you know, if it's not fighting, he won't do it. But Fihi was able to live in so many different homes and had the opportunity to meet his brother Benny's kids, his sister Siloni, which is us. And man, what an experience that would have been to grow up with everybody in your family, New Zealand, Australia, California, Utah. You spent so much time being able to love everyone that you've met. And Fihi had no problems with that. He had no problems with showing love and showing his respect to everyone. When my wife and I found out that Fihi was actually going to get married, we was really surprised. And then when we found out Aileen was Samoan, my wife, she's Samoan as well, she looked at me, she's like, it's just us Samoans, this is what we do. And she's built different. How thankful I am for Aileen, for showing Fihi the covenant path. Step before you knowing that Fihi will one day reunite with us because he was able to see and to find our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And how grateful I am to be here, to stand here, knowing that one day, we will all be together, that our families can stay forever and eternal. I want to express my love on behalf of my siblings and my mom and dad to Maylene and the girls, Paul and Tomasi. How much we love you guys. How much we appreciate you guys. Fihi was a beautiful dad. He was everything that we wanted to be. I love you. I know this see each other. Continue to watch over us as you look at them in this life. Love you, dog. I say these things in the name of my son, of course.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Just want to apologize on behalf of my older brother. He must have got lost on his way here and he found I had to do a talk. My name is Elizabeth of Hainaui Mafilel. I'm the second oldest child of Sherina Bacavello, who is Licia's sister. Licia is Halafihi's mother. I didn't really have anything planned to say, I just feel like I was going to wing it. It's here. If you know the relationship I have with Fee. She's very special to me and my family. Fihi and I were raised in the same house by our grandparents when we were younger, so he's always been a part of our lives. My very first memory ever is of Fihi. When he came to my fifth birthday and he gave me a plastic bike. And I always just thought it was a dream. I didn't actually know it was real until I confirmed it with my grandma. And I don't remember anything before that day. That was my very first memory. We've had five authors for the last week and a half, and I think I've shared more than enough memories of Fihi. There are never enough words to describe the kind of person he is. I just hope that if he's ever touched your life in any way, in any positive way, that you take the light that he's shown you, show it to the world. Earlier this week, every day I've been sharing with his beautiful wife, Mimi, just things about him. And she said to me that, I'm going to tell you how much you need to be here. I stopped her and I said, I already know. You don't have to tell me. We were very transparent. He knew how I felt about him and I knew how he felt about me. I love you, Mimi. I'll always be here for you and the girls. I love each and every one of you. Thank you so much for coming tonight and mourning with us. I love you, Fihi. I will never stop missing you. I see things happening in Shikai Senai.
Good evening, family and friends, brothers and sisters. Just those that don't know me, my name's Alipati of Hengawi. My father's Shiwa of Hengawi, my mom's Sherina Tai. I'm the third of our oldest, 12 kids of us. Robbie Jr. of Hengawi. Today I just want to express my love and spirit with you all, especially to Maylene and your beautiful children, also to Malia, Olin, Masi, Nasia, Balanisi, Waipongi, and Grandpa Joe back at home. What a week it has been for us all that we have sadly lost Halafihi, but also happy that our Heavenly Father has gained another angel. Fihi was a good father, a loving husband, a big toko to his family and also to many others here. He was a leader. He was caring in many ways spiritually and motivated, turning with love and joy 24/7. Growing up as a child until now, I'm happy to express both lives with my brother Fihi. He taught me so many things to do with life itself, through my darkest days of my life and to now my best times in life. I could stand here and talk about so many things about our brother. But unfortunately, he's probably kicked me off the stage because it's too long. But Fihi will truly be missed. Fihi, through my darkest times in my life, Fihi really did have an impact to me. Through my journey of Christ itself right now, Fihi did play a big part. And I will always truly remember the man that he was towards us, brothers and sisters, and just anyone out there, you know, had the biggest heart. I'm gonna miss him so much. And all our memories I will always cherish forever. He taught me so much things in life, you know. Love is all. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Hey everyone, I'm John Fainoa, son of Siwa Fainoa, Serena Tai, and Catherine Brown. Before I start, I just wanted to acknowledge the church for hosting our brother's funeral service. We are really grateful for it. Also acknowledge Maylene and her family for such a beautiful week. I think it's amazing what you've done for us. Accepted our culture and having us over every night, listening to us sing and sitting through it. So thank you for that, Mindy. I just want to send my love to Grandpa Bola, who's back home. Can't be over here tonight, with us here tonight. We have reasons and acknowledge all my oldies, Serena, by Bonnie. I want to say Mama Salam, but Mama Salam, we see you. I love you all. I'm so happy to have you all here. It's been a great week. I think hearing all those teammates come through and speak, they all sound the same. You know, they all said the same things about Fihi, how lovely he was, how intimidating he looked, but he was always the first person to greet him. And that was our older brother, you know, and that's how he lived his life. He'd never say anything bad about you. He was always a hit first, talk later guy. And I'm definitely one of many of his punching bags growing up. I think Frank was his main one. But I'm so grateful to stand up here and I can't share any stories because, you know, they're not too good to say up here, but I would cherish all my great memories with Halafihi. You know, he's a cousin to everyone, but in the Tongan way, there's no such thing as cousins. But he was our older brother, and he always will be. Toko, I'm gonna miss you. I know our whole family is. I love you, my brother. Thank you for being the best older brother to us all, first cousins, and our siblings. I love you all. Thank you so much for coming tonight. Say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Just after Sinoni Final, we will sing together. I feel my Savior's love, page 74.
Halafihi Tai. My dad was someone I looked up to, someone who inspired me, and someone who I truly loved and cared for. My dad, during his time with us, shared and taught me many life lessons that I would take for granted and will stick with me until the day that I pass. I grew up with my mom and dad still together. Dad had been in Australia after I turned 5. But every time we'd come to New Zealand, Mom, Mussy and I would go and welcome him. I'd run up to him, hug him, kiss him, and he'd hold my hand as we walked back to the car. As the time went by, seeing family, staying with family, and going out to have fun, Dad would eventually come back to us. Every time he'd leave, I'd cry from the time he left to the next point. This would go on for a couple of years, but up until I was 7, my parents split. They had a fallout, which means that they weren't meant to be. This took me some time to get used to, but I'm used to it now. But the lesson I had gotten out of it was how much you can truly love someone. I didn't want to talk to my dad because I thought he hated me. I thought he didn't love me anymore, so I wanted to avoid it and go on a short course. But dad did care. He'd call and call and call. He never gave up on my brother and I. His love for us never lessened, but only became stronger. There was one thing that I truly loved and learned from my father. How to love and how to care for someone so deep. He never hated anyone. He never wanted anything bad for anyone. Because like how others have said, my father had a good heart, a kind heart. That's why I loved and learned from him so much. Everyone here knows how much Dad loved the sports. So when I started playing rugby league, he was very happy to hear it. Every time I'd be on call with Dad after a game, he'd be asking my mom for any footage of me playing. I'd always say no because I really didn't have any footage. But he'd go on and on about how to play, how to run the ball, how to tackle, how to clean the ball, etc. To be honest, he was great at sports. No doubt about it, but there was one story that he repeatedly told me. I don't know if this was the truth, if he told this to anyone else, but he told me this. When my dad was young, he went to school with Sonny Bill Williams. They played rugby together. My dad said that he was the best in the team, way better than Sonny Bill Williams. So when it came time for him to go to school in America, he had freely given the opportunity to play professional rugby to Sonny Bill Williams. He had basically told me that Sonny Bill Williams stole his rugby league contract. I used to think to myself, what an idiot. Why did you have to get kicked out of school back then? But the thing is, I never say what I thought out loud because I was extremely scared of him. But Dad, just so you know, I really don't. But for your ego, Dad, I believe you're better than him. Mine was better than him. I think you're better than him in every way and in everything. Because you're just that guy. You're a car for everything and anything. You dedicated your time and worked on the things you needed to do to become better. You told me that every time I laid out to you what I want to do in my life and what I want to become, you say, son, work hard for everything. Now everything's given to you freely. If you truly want it, you gotta work hard for it. You're an example for me on how to work hard. You worked hard on rugby, Dad. You won leagues. You worked hard on your business, Dad. It grew. That you worked hard to change your life and you changed. You became better and lived better. I don't know if I ever told you this, Dad. I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of who you became when you left us. You changed who you were and gave your life back to Christ. You became an even better father to your kids, a better son, brother, nephew, grandchild, friend, uncle, to everyone here. You've become a role model for us to look back to encourage us to change, to encourage us to become better, just like you did. Dad, my memories that I shared with you will never fade. They'll never go away. They might leave my mind someday, but they'll never leave my heart. I'm so proud of you, Dad, and I love you so much. Until I see you again, Dad, in the next life. Halafihi Tai. I see these things in the name of Jesus Christ, Amen.
Stop my speech. I'd like to thank everyone for being here and remembering Dad's life. Even though I didn't get to see my dad very much, still kept in contact with us. One memory that comes to mind is when me and Dad would play together on games. I know it sounds small, but I love this memory because so many people talk to me.
Siblings. Firstly, I'd like to, on behalf of my siblings and my little family, I'd like to take this time to say thank you to Paula, Pai Pongi, Isil, Nisi, the rest of his family, for your love that you have shown, the sacrifices you have all made to raise my Orotoko. I would like to come say a few words. I was ready to run, to be honest, and I wasn't ready tonight. Fihi, in the short time that I got to know you, and hearing all the stories about you from many different people and walks of life, maybe your teammates in different teams to play with, your cousins, your brothers, aunties, and truly the same proud for the man you've become. Maybe, thank you, I love you, our own brother. To the girls, his boys. I love you, man. If you ever need anything, we're all here for you. Say these things in the name of Jesus Christ, I want to. Amen.
To your justice, I'm not used to it. Wearing this dandala in honor of my dear son. good evening, brothers and sisters, family and friends. My name is Maylene Salome Matali, and I am Maylene's mother-in-law, for his second mother. I'm grateful to stand for you tonight to share a few thoughts and a few memories of our relationship with our dearest Fee in our home or in our family. I think I'll start with telling you about how Fee came to our home and the first time we heard and saw Fee. We first heard about this Tongan man that our daughter was dating behind our backs. Back 8 years ago, about other people's children, and that's how we knew. That's how we knew about Fiki and Mayim. Okay, then we call Fiki. So, to cut the story short, so we heard that Mayim was dating this Tongan man with long hair, and we heard that he was married before, and he had two kids. So when we heard that, I was all right with it, but my husband decided to tell me he was furious. He was angry, and the hatred that my husband had on me, I don't know how to explain. My husband told Mayim, we don't want to see that man again. My husband doesn't like Tonga, sorry, Samai. So he told Mayim never to see or go out with Fiki again. So Mayim decided to sneak out of the house every night. She thought that we don't know, but we knew that she was sneaking out of the house. So after a few months, I think they had a little talk and then started to come and bring Fiki to show him to us, or meet the parents, as they call it. The day that Fiki decided to come and meet us, it was a Sunday afternoon. I think he chose Sunday because he thinks that the holy is a holy day, and people will be holy, and nothing will happen to them. So it was a Sunday afternoon, just after church. We went home, and we had prepared the album, I call it in Samoan. My husband didn't know that Fiki was coming that day, but all the kids and the family knew that Fiki was on his way to meet us that Sunday afternoon. I think my husband, in his mind, as a Samoan parent, he was expecting the first man that comes to us, his daughter, in marriage. He was expecting Fiki to come with a puaka or a isupo, that's how the Samoan, when you first go to introduce yourself to a Samoan family and ask them in marriage, you take those stuff, isupo, paero, and stuff like that. So I think my husband was expecting that something like that from Fiki, or when he was decided to meet us. So that Sunday, when Fiki came, my husband was in the other living room. So the kids welcomed him into our home, and they stayed on the other side of the house. So I said to my husband, "Oh, the Maggie's friends here," and he said, "You better tell them to go out. I think if my husband had a gun that day, he would shoot him right." He was ready to finish me that day. So I felt very sorry for Fiki. So here I was begging my husband, so you better go and say hello to the man. Look at Pepe's face, and just welcome him and just say something. My husband wouldn't budge. He was just a stubborn man. So poor Fiki was just sitting there waiting for my husband to come and welcome him to our home. After a few minutes, or maybe an hour or so, Fiki decided to go. I said to Bebe, "You better tell Fiki to go. Your dad is very angry. And if you do something to Fiki, he'll do something to you too. So you better tell Fiki to go." So it went like that, Fiki went. My husband was very angry. He had no intention of welcoming Fiki into our home. From all the stories that people were telling him about him being a gang member, or he was a very bad boy back then, we heard. So that's why my husband was very angry, and he didn't want Bebe to marry him or anything to do with Fee. But that all changed when Raylene came into our lives. The minute we held Raylene, that hatred all disappeared. And that was the beginning of a loving relationship we had with Fee up until now. I felt so sorry for him that day. And I said to my husband, I knew I'm a very good man. Just look at your son. Treat Fee like your own son. He was very angry at him from all these stories that people were selling. And lucky that he came the day my husband was already retired from boxing. My husband used to be a boxer. He told him when on their wedding day, you better be careful because I was a boxer too, so you know. So lucky he came that day, my husband already had up his boxing gloves. I had to jump down some notes, you know, as you get old, your memories get faded. And when my husband passed away unexpectedly, just like Fee, I felt I could stand very strong. But since Fee's passing, I've been devastated, to tell you the truth. I've never cried when my husband passed away. Maybe because I was relying on Fee to help Nevin in our family, especially when it comes to performing priesthood responsibilities in our home. Because my husband was already gone, and I think that's why I was devastated when I heard Fee's passing. Many questions came to mind when he was gone. I asked the question, why did Heavenly Father take Fee away from us when we need him here? I was asking questions, why is Heavenly Father punishing me? He had taken four special people in my life. First was my husband. He died unexpectedly, just like Fee, 3 years ago. So first was my husband, then my dad, after 4 months of my husband's passing, my dad passed away. And within, I think in a year or so, our darling Messiah, Fee and Bebe's son passed away too, and now Fee. So I was questioning Heavenly Father's, I'm a very active person in the church. I fulfill my callings, I do all those things, good things. But why is he punishing me and my family? Then I remembered I was asked to share a talk during our state conference last month. Brother Lakisa asked me to share a talk on overcoming a faith crisis. In that talk, when I was studying for that talk, I came across a quote given by Richard G. Scott. And he said, when you face adversity, you can be led to ask many questions. Some serve a useful purpose, others do not. Asking questions will only lead you into blind alleys. It really does no good to ask questions that reflected opposition to the will of God. Rather, ask, what am I to do? What am I to learn from this experience? or how can I remember my many blessings in times of trials? This life is an experience in profound truth. Trust. Trust in Jesus Christ, trust in his teachings, trust in our capacity that's led by the Holy Spirit to obey those teachings. To trust means to obey willingly without knowing the end from the beginning. To produce fruit, your trust in the Lord must be more powerful and enduring your confidence in your own personal feelings and experience. End quote. I understand the heartbreak of separation from loved ones, but Jesus is the light that shines in the dark. He is the way, the truth, and life. He atoned to help each of us find the covenant path that leads us back to our Heavenly Father. I'm sure most of you know that, or have read a letter that Maybe posted on her social media. The letter that Fihi wrote at the beginning of this year. At the end of that letter, that he was writing about how he felt about his family. So he told his five children that he loved them very much. And at the end of that letter, he said, "But don't get married." He told Manny, "Don't get married. Well, Fee, your wish is my command. I will make sure that Manny never, ever get married again. So you can leave that with me." If my talk is long, well, I'm the only one from Manny's family, so the Tongans are all taking my advice. So bear with me. My children wrote this song, so I'm saying or reading this on behalf of your brothers and sisters, nephews and nieces, Fee. Fee was a well-loved member of our family. Fee married into our family, but my husband and I always remind my kids' spouses that we didn't see them as our children in law, but as our actual children. So that was the same with Fihi. Fihi did a lot in our family. He was a worthy priesthood holder, not only within the walls of his own home, for his wife and children, but he also took part in many blessings. Baptisms for his nieces and nephews and other children. He was a loving father to his wife and children. I will miss seeing the way he loved them. We loved his sports, and he was a loyal and passionate supporter to the teams he supported. I'm sure everyone who loved followed Fihi will know how much he loved updating his Facebook statuses. My favorite memory of Fihi, I'll start again. Fee and I have a very close relationship. The only time we have our differences is the time of state of origin. Just because Fee he supported the Blues, I supported the Queensland. So I think he does this on purpose to make me angry. The last state of origin, I did a post because he loves posting stuff on Facebook. So I think he did this on purpose. So I decided to put a picture of a gun on my Facebook page, and Anita Nautu was teasing him, "You better watch out or your mother-in-law will use that gun on you." But that was just a joke. I think that's enough stories. Fihi knows that I love you. Fihi, I love you very much. I am glad that I was able to share all of your achievements. Yahona and Peyton. We will make sure that you are proud of them in the future. I will keep on reminding them how great their dad was. So he was a very hardworking man. He had two jobs, and I would see him every day working until they run business now, and it's always Fihi that runs that. And he does that all for his family, for his wife and kids. Thank you, Fihi, for respecting me as your mother-in-law. Thank you for loving me, but especially for loving Pepe and the girls. I will never forget you. As I promised you, I will look after your girls as long as I live. And that's a promise I will keep. I love you so much, but I'm going to wish you. In everything we do in our family, you have a good journey home. I know you're happy with Messiah. You'll be happy with Messiah and Dad. You give my husband the biggest hug when you see him and tell him that I miss him. You watch over us, especially Pepe and the girls. And until that glorious morning when I get to hug you again and kiss you again, you rest easy. I love you very much, so I miss you. But today I feel when we touch on May 5th. What about we know you? So I'm going to fight out your way. We're to be of Dayo, to Rufa, to Maki Ali. Me Ali, to be so similar to our two for I found a million to a year to fight to do what we know for our own. I'm going to work to that. They often to you, may me and Anna find out for Bernie Ali. And I'm going to us for 30 years to Uma, who soon to Mali. And I tell you, I have to take a baby in the roof from the other day. Or open from my family, or team, or Emma, or basically say, my source in this out of fire before the woman may die. In fact, my real need to wear to your door. Or to fire in my mouth, or to my mom in the time of the day. If father of our wife, it is well for you to carry so. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I'm so very grateful for this opportunity that I'm able to stand here and just share a few words. My name is Halafihi Tai. Tapate, I'm married to a Samoan as well. So your family's converted to Samoans. Fihi's my younger brother. Growing up, it's always been me and Halafihi. Halafihi, get home, my boy. I was truly blessed to have you as my brother. Taught me to share, to love. It was always me for you. It was my worst of the all honor. And it was me for you having grown up. Fihi was that young brother that used to annoy the big sister. And that was our mom and our relationship growing up. I remember when Fihi was young, he used to get bullied at school. He used to be a kid that get pushed around. Fihi used to come home running to me and tell me, and I was the sister that would go to school and deal with the person that messed with my little brother. wasn't until my mom, actually told my brother to fight. Fee started fighting and became an actual fighter. I got kicked out of school for fighting. One thing I love about my brother is he kept in touch with every single person that he's ever met, and he always checked in on them. He's got so many friends in New Zealand growing up. We grew up in a dorm, and I know how much everyone back home, that I know they can't leave the country to come here. But Fee, I know they all love you very much. I see videos of them hanging out on O'Donnell, reminiscing on memories. I know a lot of them look up to you because of the man that you became, not because of the person that you were before, but you were a walking testimony of how a person can change and come unto Christ wholeheartedly. And I'm so very proud of you, Fee. I remember the last time we were here in Brisbane, I got to witness my brother baptize little Brittany. And I was so proud to see Fee perform these same ordinances. So beautiful to be able to see him, his life, the way it turned out to be. One thing I regret I didn't share with my brother was when I was able to, I was blessed to serve a full-time mission in the Australia Brisbane mission, the greatest mission, Brisbane. I remember being in the mission, I left at a time when he was hitting rock bottom in his life. And when I served, I would pray for being fast for me. Even if I had to sacrifice 18 months for you, I served there for you. Asking Heavenly Father to please to bless you with a miracle, to have that change of heart. Obviously it didn't happen overnight, but eventually it happened. And I know God is the God of miracles. Answers prayers. I know that each and every one of us here miss him, love and be. But I know that prayer really does work. Maylene, I want you to know that I'll always be here for you. For you and the girls, Raylene, Diana, Caitlin. So for my boys, Paul and Tomasi, I want you to say I'll always be here for you. He always knew I had his back. I'll drop anything for me, for his kids. I remember when he asked me if he could name his daughter Raylene after me, I was like, hey? I was really happy and excited. But I honestly didn't think that he was. Name was born after me, but Fee, it's an honor and a privilege to have your first daughter named after me. Right now I'm lost for words, but I know the time is running short. But I know one message I want to give is that families can be together forever. And one thing I'm really proud to see my brother go, he's gone to the temple. And he's sealed to his wife and kids all eternity to me. Life does not end here. And this is not the end. It's not a goodbye, it's more of a see you later, bro. Thank you for setting the example for the boys in our family. And I pray that each and every one of you may learn from me and be able to follow the example that he's left behind us. I just want to thank you to everyone here, the ward and all his friends, his rugby friends, friends from New Zealand, a friend from America, who's traveled near and far to be able to mourn. We love you all very much. We love you for loving Fiji. We love all the stories you're able to share with all of us. Thank you for being here for him. And also her siblings, all her siblings. So my sister from Utah. Just everyone. I know some Vinny's family from Utah came as well, and from Melbourne, New Zealand. We love you all, and we're very grateful that you're able to show up with me. And all the boys, thank you for always showing up. There's this famous line that Mickey always says, you gotta come through, you gotta come down. That's just what I think I started like, I like saying that. But also to my dad, he's not here, he's in New Zealand. I cried for him so much. You all know how much he loved me. The person that you see, Fiji, he's a mirror of our father, exactly. Always rocking me, loves everyone, talks to every person, will never make you feel left out. My dad's been driving around to all the spots Fiji likes, like his very first chip shop, to the rugby fields Fiji used to play on, and my dad would just drive around. And I know he's watching. But one thing I want you to know, that is to remember, you will see in me. I know that the church is true. I know that our Savior, Jesus Christ, lives. I know that whatever path we're in life, it's never too late to turn. Our Savior, Jesus Christ, has always opened arms. I know that the Book of Mormon is another testament of Christ. I know that if you read it and pray like God, if it's true, you will receive an answer if you have faith in Christ. I love you all very much, and I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
My name is Sloan, aka Mama Sloan, and my sister Sharina, and she was called to come up here. She was so nervous that she couldn't come up. So I told her, I'm just gonna come with you, okay? It's gonna be okay, Sharina. And this is how we were growing up back home. As a little kid, we're always together as a twin. Back home, people think we're twins. But we are. This is our little brother, Fiji, aka Auntie. We're known as Big Mama to Halafihi. When he's mad, he always calls us, hey, Big Mama. Then I'll turn around, you mean your Mama Lucia? That's Big Mama. I just want to just say that we're happy to be here. Vaka took turn saying my part, and Sharina's kids were up here expressing their love to Halafihi. And Halafihi know that we love him because we spoil him from day one, from diapers. Right, Sherry? When I went on my mission, I was 18. I went to Tonga on my mission. And I got back, you know, Sharina was already married. Lucia was married to Falapisi. And Halafihi was running around. And he was a little naughty boy. It was about four adults at the house. Fihi will be jumping from this chair up here, there, here, and somebody will slap him. That will be me. Fihi, sit down. You don't jump around when people are around at the house. So I'm just letting you know that we love you, Fihi. Fihi already know that. I'm just grateful that he came to spend his time with us, with Stevenie and Fane, back in LA. Fihi, I remember that day you were picked to be an all-star football, D.I.M. yelling out. You know, my kids wasn't playing football at the time. I'd be like, cheering hot out. I was just proud. Sister, that's my brother. Fihi would do a play and hit so hard. Then I'll be like, Fihi, that's me, that's my brother, that's Tai. Because he has a tie in the back of his jersey, right? And Fihi, we love you. Can't say more much. You want to say something? Off after Fihi. Sorry, my sisters, we have this trouble as a panic attack. So if anyone asks me or even Licia to say something, she'll go, oh, I'm giving you a heart attack. That was like when we had that thing back home for Fihi, and Fihi's friends, they all came and wanted her to give her support and stuff. And she was like, oh, I don't want to say anything in my, you know, I just want to be with her. And I said, you're going to be all right. You're not going to die. She goes, no, I'm going to get my heart attack. I was like that today. When my name came up and I turned around and I said to the storm, oh my gosh, my heart is going to stop. And then my sister turned around and said to me, no, you're going to be fine. I'm going to be with you up there. And I said, okay, I'm fine. Fihi, on the day when my sister called me, I was asleep. My phone rang 3 times. I keep picking it up, saw my sister's name, and I was going, oh no, I don't want to talk about Matima Toma. That is a sound more team. I had enough. I'm going to go to sleep. Second time, I looked at her again, and I was going, what if it's an emergency? So I said, hello? And I heard her screaming. And I sat up and I said, sis, what's happening? Oh, Halafihi Tai. And I was going, look around, am I dreaming? And I said, what did you say? Halafihi Tai, he got killed. Oh my gosh, it's just because I want people. Always care and always bringing me every day. He goes, sis, are you okay? You need smarts? And I said, look at my packet, I have four left. I said, yes, I need a new one. So, Fihi, I'm going to need all that. You were the firstborn to the Thai family. And we spoiled you so much. We didn't know you as a grandson. We know you as a brother to us. You were the youngest out of all the Thai brothers. Two of our brothers, Stephen, Anthony, Morris, and you were the youngest one out of it. I guess Fihi turned like that because it was us, the way we were spoiling him. We spoiled him so much, we gave him whatever he wanted. At 14, he came and asked to borrow my car, I gave it to him. I gave him the key. Go to the nightclub, he came and asked me, sis, can I use your car? Because I'm going to take my friends to the city. And I said, no. I can drive you to the nightclub if you want. And he goes, can you? And I said, yes, I can take you to the nightclub if you want to, because I got lots of people that knows me in the club. So I took him there. And then I watched him. I said, I'll watch you. What are you going to do at the club? There's nothing. I'm just going to sit around with my friends. So Nasi, Francis, and them. So I took them all to the club, and I sat there and watched them. So, Fihi, now that you're gone, we got nobody to spoil anymore. And I know we got heaps. We even got my children here who came all the way from Auckland. Thank you. The rest of my children that you guys never met, got 10 children. So I've got Mosiana, Kayla, Henrietta, Eliza, twins, Beto and Doc. They're the youngest out of all the four ones. And my husband's Macabella. And my name, sorry, I should have said my name earlier. Sherina Evelyn Tai Macabella. And my husband just turned up with my thank you to my family, my sisters, sister-in-laws, Mercedes and Paya, and husband Melopa. Thank you. So I think, if we might be getting a lot of power, I'll keep going. Now, if my power is getting a lot, I'll go in north. And all your friends back at home, they're probably outside and under the tree watching the live stream again. No, I offer like my kakoikato, maybe Okalan Musi, or Fati.
Fihi, I forgot about my husband's love. Remind me of Offalaya Kakoe. See, Offalaya, Anthony, Moidono, Raylene, Moyamoti. I have to remember all my kids. We have 18 grandkids, and we, you know, my hair is getting gray because Joe was calling me the oldie, was looking up. And I said, yeah, I am old. I'm old. Okay, Ofa Kamoto, thank you, Bishop, for allowing us to have this up. Just want to say, Melin, Ofa Lahat Kapoe, and to your mom, Melin, thank you. Thank you for having us and having Fihi and loving Fihi. Offa la hiatu to all of you, ta offa, a offa. Offa me, Ray, and your mother-in-law, Fihi's mother-in-law. All I'm from, I see offa, come on. Offa, get back home.
Brothers and sisters, thank you for your patience. Just for our interlude, we'll only sing one verse. And
To change his life.
And I'm grateful he baptized my my daughter, Brittany. And always cherish everything he's done to me and my family, especially when I live away. Too many stories about being good and bad. I think the only story I can say about him, especially with me and my cousins. If you guys ever watched the movie Friday, there's a character there, his name's Debo. So this character, he's like the neighborhood bully. He's a stand-up guy. Us growing up with Fee, anything he'll say, we'll always listen. You know, and then as soon as he goes, we all start, you know, backstabbing him. You know, and then when he comes back, we're all quiet. Especially my cousin Boyki. You all good now, Ducks. Debo's gone. He can open up now. On the wheels, I miss my double. No one here to lead the family. To acknowledge my brother's sister, Bashapa and Sane, and to Bailey and the girls, Paul and Thomas. I'm here for you guys. I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
He taught me a lot of new stuff. Every time he would ask me to help him, I would always have an excuse. I regret that now. I'm gonna miss you, Fee. Jimmy Lee and Paula Thomas, Brady Homer, and Caitlin, I love you. And to everyone that traveled overseas, thank you for coming.
Wow.
My name is Falisi Pongrafi. I'm the oldest to Shota's kids.
Y está en pena, bajo para colocar la mano, o si yo me he ido, le hago una parada, y junto con todo el cartón, al cordón, la mujer, no para parar. Le hago para colocar la oreja, y entonces la cama y no hago, jaja. La puerta aquí. I'm getting old. Saya pengen lihat kartón. Nampak macam rumah kau tau mah. Oh, fikir apa tu saya rumah dia ke ni ke. Bagi soh aku ni. Aku mau kau punah lah kita HP ni. Aku mau kau punah. Halafihi kisyon ni berantan. Kau tak ingat lah. Halafihi kau yang main mehen ni kuih. Kau halafihi nama dia ni kau ingat tak halafihi. Pahala beba o to ohingo ekta mai, ohingo awa, halafihi kisione bea tai. Toi ai oko. Ana wohi kaki foha koe ni, kupi moko puna, ana hange pia ha, haku. Tama na aku whanaui, na ngahe pia e au. Tanya mo na ngahi, ihe taimi na aku ngawe, ke ngawe ba angai. And I love my lady baby. Oh, my man, ha, oh, father, I'm here. Time is out. My show up. I have forgot to get a coffee shop of now, me, I've been money. Now, what I think, what I get to up. We know I've been a bishop, but I think I'm right for me. Time. That's where I'm going. Make it go. Taka opo opo tahai, tonga taku po vei tomo. Hala ko lewa. Pea. Ihe tai na aroa a ahati ki Amerika. Aroa kuihe pia. Pea, pekao lewa pia ahati. Ke foki mai ki Nusila. Fa o fa no fue America, a saika America, a saika te ka no fue America. A ti a toi ka no sira, ka o va o va si. Fa o fa, e ga na we, ko to ho he ga we ia te, va he, ta e va he, me ga ia ni ta e va he. Pe a, se ga le va pe fo pi ma na ma, ta to mo ko ha la hi ta ha o no fue America ia mo ma, fa na ko ne un kita mai ti a. Tak mai ia ke, hal di Nusira tu hal dia mak di Nusira, bukan. Kau itu ya, kau orang halafihi kiai.
to deliver the jobs. So sometimes I would go with him to help, even though he would. My dad always wanted to work. He always took care of us, of me and my mom and my sisters when we were sick or sad. I love you, Daddy, so much. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Much time because I also have the privilege of speaking to my about my beloved husband. I've listened to so many memories, and like what Joe said, even though there's been different teams, three different teams, there have been several people from all walks of life. Everybody sounds the same. Everybody has similar things to say. He was kind-hearted. He was always welcoming. He was so kind. He had a very warm heart. And he had, he was definitely blessed with the gift of gathering. If you know my husband, you know that he loved gatherings. He loved people together, and especially those who he really loved. In 2014, Halafihi and I were on a similar journey of really trying to find ourselves. And in that process, we found each other. I knew almost immediately how kind he was. And it wasn't because of the big things, it was the small things that he did. And why I say he was one of the first out of the boys to grab a chair for us girls or give up his own seat. He was always wanting to serve and always looking for opportunities to help others, even though he was on a journey of trying to find himself, trying to build himself. He would always look to help others before himself. I'll begin. beginning, like you would have heard my mum say, it wasn't very smooth at all. You can definitely say that our love story didn't have a beautiful beginning. We didn't have the support of all our family members. And we were both quite weak spiritually. But what we did find and come to know is that we loved each other very much. We both knew that being together would require some sacrifice. But we were willing because of our love. We were willing because we both had the same end goal of being truly happy. And we knew that same we knew even with our past that true happiness that we were both seeking could only be found in one place, and that's here through the gospel of Jesus Christ. The journey for us was rough, and at times we wanted to give up, but we fought together. And the day finally came in 2019, where we were able to achieve our biggest goal. We received our own endowment and were sealed to each other and our children for all time and all eternity. Figure was willing to do anything and absolutely everything for me. He did quite literally do everything for me. I've had a little laugh to some this past week when I thought, oh my gosh, I have to put my own petrol in my car. I have to wash my own dishes. I have to drive myself around now. Because my husband always wanted to make sure that I was resting, even though I got so much rest. He wanted to make sure that I was comfortable and that I was happy. I was always taken care of. And even when problems came, I never worried too much or too long. Just being took that all. He took that all from me. When my dad and our son passed away, everyone told me that I was so strong. Everyone told me that they didn't know how I managed to cope so well. And when Fee left last Monday, he took a lot of that strength with him. Because he was my backbone, even though he always used to say that I was his. He did a lot to hold me up during these times. I never felt like my burdens were too heavy, because he was always right beside me, carrying me with me. When I was in pain, he always used to say to me, I wish I could take your pain and give it to myself. That's the kind of eternal partner that I chose. He and I started a business together that requires a lot of heavy lifting. A lot of moving objects for events. On the day before he left, we had several events. And I'll never forget the last event that we did together. heaviest backdrops that that we own. And when we got to the event, he said, I want to try to carry this myself. We usually carry it together, carry everything together. He grabbed this really large backdrop and put it over his shoulders. And I walked behind him, just watching him, but I could see that it was heavy. I could see he was struggling. When we walked back to the car, he said, "Baby, you okay? You're so strong." And he just laughed and said, "No, I'm not." He said, "That was really heavy." But he said, "That whole time, I was just thinking of you. I was just thinking of you. Because I didn't want you to carry anything heavy." We just laughed about it afterwards. But now I just, I'm amazed at how well my husband took care of me. I could speak on this man, truly. I think I could speak on him for a while. And I think even still I wouldn't be able to express how truly great this man was. I loved him from the beginning. Truly from the beginning. We always used to laugh and he would say that that I said I loved him first. That's a lie. He really did tell me that he loved me first. Even though our time together wasn't the longest, I have faith. I truly have faith in our forever. I have faith in the covenants that we made a new temple to our Heavenly Father and to one another. And I know these promises are definite if I'm able to endure to the end. I've been thanked by a lot of people this past week for helping Fee to change his life. And as much as I'd love to take credit, I can't take that credit away from Fee. That credit truly goes to Fee himself and to our Heavenly Father. I pushed my husband so hard. Because I saw in him something that sometimes I don't. I always tried to see my husband, as annoying as he was sometimes, I always tried to see him as Heavenly Father does. And I always knew that even with a past as dark as Fee's, through Christ, even he could change. That even through the tangled roads that Fee walked on, there was always a way for him to return. My husband was a prodigal son. He lived and he loved the world for so many years of his life. But I find comfort in knowing that in his latter years, he chose to return home. I know that he was truly happy with his life, with our lives, before he left. But I also know my husband, and I'm quite certain that he would not have left without Heavenly Father would have helped me and reminded him that it's his will, that his plans are perfect, that his timing is perfect. Together, sometimes we would read scriptures in Psalm 1 and Psalm 2 because Fee was determined to learn Psalm 1. He may have been Matema Adoma, but my husband was, he supported me before anything else. So he was diehard Psalm 1 at heart. Even though he never managed to pick up the language quite well, I feel it's only right that I say something in Tongan to his parents, his grandparents, and as you've heard, the many people that that raised Halafihi. Kia pola, mubai pongi. Pehekio, isi ama falanisi. O ki mongtolo kutoa pea, a mongtokoni, ki hono a hihake o pihi. O kua, I kai te omo hale o te ona, ke whakamalo atu. A ki, he mongi a mati, whakaoko o pano, o mawohi ha. In love, and so much that thou shalt weep for the loss of them that die. DNC 42-44. Thank you to all those who have showed their love, their support, their kindness towards myself and my family. So much of this week has been bearable because of your thoughts, your prayers, and the love that you have shown in every form. I have a testimony of this gospel. I know through the covenants that I've made. I know that families are forever. I know that our family is eternal. I find comfort in the gospel. And I know that my Savior has walked. He has walked the hardest paths before me. And because of that, I know that I can also walk these paths. I know my Heavenly Father loves me. Even through these trials, I know that He loves me. I know that He is not too far away from me. And I guess I have to keep the promise and not get married, like I said. But if you see me married again, mind your business. I'm just kidding. I like this gospel. I love the strength that I receive because I know that Christ loves and He loves me. him isn't easy. And I know that my faith has been tried and tested. But I know that Heavenly Father gives nothing to us that we can't manage. I love you, V. I am eternally yours. Although the journey seems like a very long one, a very hard one, I know that you will wait for me. And I look forward to that day. Very humbly, in the name of our Lord, Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, thank you all for all those who have participated in our program this evening. Now, Maylene, are you telling me that picture there with Fiji doing the tea is not Mati Maradona, is that a Toa? I always knew this guy was halfway. So pleased. Maylene, on behalf of my family, I want to give you our blessing. But it's okay if you go and get married, okay? You can go get married. I know Fihi wouldn't want to see you cry alone. He wouldn't want to see you walk, continue to walk on this journey alone. He would want the best for you. So I know this is all jokes at there, but it's all right. You have our support. We love you, Megan. Brothers and sisters, just one thing that just came to my mind as I came towards the end of the book of Nephi. Now, we know of the prophet Lehi. When the Lord commanded Lehi to leave Jerusalem, to take his family into the wilderness, we learned that they suffered many afflictions. And as I reflect on that story, we can look at that story and take that into our own lives, that we are on our own personal journeys with our Savior Jesus Christ. The wilderness is our time here in this earth. We are all in the wilderness. Now, Fihi has departed from the wilderness. He's moved on to the promised land. Now, that was the commandment from the Lord for Lehi to take his family out of Jerusalem, and he would lead them to the promised land. Maylene, I just want to read you this quote. No one went to the promised land without first going through the wilderness. As I mentioned to you, this time here on earth is our journey in the wilderness. As Lehi and his children suffered many afflictions and sufferings, we too will face similar trials and challenges. But the way that they made it to the promised land was because of their faith in Jesus Christ. Now, Maylene, you may not remember, but when this all first happened, we had a Zoom meeting, and your closing remarks was, I have faith. Families are forever. And those words struck to my soul because of your faith. It lighted that burden that we all felt. It reflected your covenant that you made with your husband Halafihi, being sealed to him, not only in this life, but for eternity. Brothers and sisters, this is my message to us all, that the time is now to prepare to meet God. Our time here on earth is limited. We all are given the same 24 hours. Some of us are able to do many things. Some of us, we don't use up those 24 hours to the way we should be. But this time here on earth, once again, brothers and sisters, is for us to prepare to meet God. We already know Fihi. We know Fihi's past, his upbringing in the church. There was a little bit of a, hey, how are you going? But Fihi has left this earth his happiest. And I say that because he has found what he was searching for, and that was the gospel of Jesus Christ. And he found it through, with Maylene. And so Maylene, thank you from the bottom of my heart and from our family. We thank you for helping Halafihi stay on the path that leads us back to our Father in heaven. I know that Halafihi did all that he could to return back to our Father in heaven. He was a faithful follower of Jesus Christ. He loved you. He loves you. He loved the girls. And so, if you ever find someone, Maylene, make sure it's someone that could do the same thing, that could love you as Halafihi did, and love the girls. Brothers and sisters, I bear you my testimony that Jesus is the Christ, and Jesus lives. He died and is resurrected, and because he is resurrected, Fihi too one day will be resurrected with his body that lays in front of us. He is only dead temporarily, but the day will come where his body will be reunited with his spirit, for his spirit continues to live. Fihi, I love you. I'm forever grateful for your example. You changing 180 was the greatest example to us all. Maylene, we love you. We love your girls. Paula, Tomasi, we're always here. You can always count on my brothers and all your boys to come and wash a path for you. You've got plenty of them over here, so you can always call them. On a serious note, we thank you all, family, friends, brothers and sisters. Thank you for your time this evening. Thank you for coming out and showing respect and support to us through these difficult times. Our burdens do feel lighter. Jesus is the only one, Mary, that can heal a broken heart. I know this. He loves you. He loves us all. I'm grateful for the leaders behind me. May God continue to watch each and every one of us. May he continue to be upon us as we depart from here. This is my testimony. I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
grateful for the for that blessing and for the safety that thou has provided us. We ask thee at this time to watch over us and continue blessing us as we walk about our ways, that we may do so safely. Father, we ask thee to bless that we may be able to remember the memories that we have of our beloved faith, that we may continue cherishing these memories and be able to share. Father, we ask thee to bless us that we may continue with his light in our life, that we may be able to spread it to those that are around us. Father, bless us that we may be able to be safe and be able to return back home safely as we